We're going to take a look at how to add this eye blink transition to your video created completely in Final Cut Pro. Hey guys, what's up? This is Serge and welcome back to my channel for another Final Cut Pro tutorial. First, set your playhead between your two clips and move it back about 2 seconds by pressing Ctrl P and entering minus, 2, and period. Press Enter to move your playhead back 2 seconds. Next, open the effects browser, select the masks category, and drag and drop a shape mask over your first clip. In the viewer, zoom out on your clip, and use the on-screen controls to adjust the shape to better resemble eyelids. First, drag the white curvature circle all the way to the right to make your shape into an oval. Next, use the green handles to adjust the shape of the mask until the inside frame is just on the outside of your clip. Drag the feather ring out until the value in the inspector is at about 200. Add a keyframe to the radius parameter, and click on the disclosure triangle beside the transform parameter and add a keyframe to the position values. Move the playhead ahead about 25 frames by either using the right arrow key or pressing Ctrl P and entering plus, 2, 5, and enter. Click and drag either the top or the bottom handle on your mouse to partially close it. Move the playhead ahead another 9 or 10 frames and adjust the shape mask until it appears almost completely open. Move ahead 18 frames and pull one of the vertical handles all the way in towards the middle of the frame. You'll still see a little bit of light in the middle of your frame because of the feathering. Without moving your playhead, add a keyframe to the feather parameter in the inspector. Move the playhead ahead 2 more frames and drag the feather slider all the way down. Your clip should now look like this. Now, let's copy this mask to your next clip. With your first clip selected, press Command-C on your keyboard to copy this clip. Select your second clip and press Shift-Command-V to paste only the attributes from your first clip. In the pop-up window, make sure you have Shape Mask selected, and at the bottom, for keyframe timing, select Stretch to Fit. This will paste your Shape Mask and all the keyframes onto your second clip. Next, you need to delete the keyframes from the first clip and re-animate the mask. With your second clip selected, in the inspector, click on the hooked arrows beside all the keyframe parameters. Resize your shape mask until it's about the same shape as you started with in the first clip. Set your playhead at the start of the second clip, and from there, move it ahead about 20 frames. Adjust your shape mask to eyes closed position and bring the feather slider down until the screen is completely black. Add a keyframe here to the feather and the radius parameters. Move the playhead 2 frames ahead and set the feather value to 200. Move ahead 10 frames and adjust the mask until it's about half open. Move 5 frames ahead and close it again. Manually add a keyframe to the feather parameter. Move 2 frames ahead and bring the slider down. Move 2 more frames ahead and set the value at 200 again. Manually add a keyframe to the radius parameter here. Move ahead 8 frames and adjust the mask so it's almost completely open. Move 3 frames ahead and close the mask. Now move 5 frames ahead and completely open the mask. Now, to make this effect look a little more realistic, let's add and keyframe a bit of blur to our clips. In the effects browser, select the blurs category and add the Gaussian blur effect to both clips. What you need to do next is line up the blur amount with the keyframes you set for the mask. Ctrl-click on your first clip and select Show Video Animation. This shows you all the keyframes set for your shape mask. Set your playhead on the first keyframe and bring the blur amount slider all the way down. Add a keyframe here. Move to the second keyframe and bring the amount up to about 30. Move to the next keyframe and bring the slider down to 15. Move to the last keyframe and set the blur amount to about 60. Let's move to the second clip. Open the video animation and set your playhead on the first keyframe. Set the blur amount to 60 and add a keyframe. Move ahead a couple keyframes and set the blur amount to about 30. move 4 keyframes ahead, and manually add a keyframe to the blur amount slider. Move to the next keyframe and bring the blur amount all the way down. Your clip should now look something like this. This does take a little bit of time and messing around, but the finished result looks pretty cool. If you want an easier way to accomplish the same effect, come back for my next video where I'll show you how you can download and install a custom plugin that accomplishes everything we did today. The plugin will be available free of charge for a limited time for my subscribers, so if you haven't yet, hit the subscribe button and click on the bell to turn on notifications so you don't miss it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week.